We are live
for TC News.
That is the Christchurch Town Hall, and we're going to perform there our last song, as a my last song, me and Nick's last song ever, performing the Blue Notes at a big sing.
We're here to sing, and we're here to sing big.
Hell yeah! Yeah. Now I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear. It's a truth, and I owe it all to you. 'Cause I had the time of my life, and I owe it all to you.
Welcome everyone. I've got a cool meeting for you guys today. Four course. Some of you have been here before, I think. Most of you are new. Our first course we're about to bring out is going to be a beetroot tartare, which was tossed in some truffle oil, shallots, and with chives. So the beetroot with salt bake, just think of it, kind of season it before it kind of goes in the oven. Sort of have an opener, if you will, sort of nice and earthy with the truffle and that kind of thing.
Bring out now.
Alright, this is our second course. So before this course, because we have power in it, we're going to get Odigwa to do a cut of here to sort of properly start off the meal. Awesome. So what we have here is a tawatawa lime and grains with the hazel vein on a base of a whipped Greek yogurt. A little palate cleanser, it should be nice and sort of citrusy, get your, you know, mouth going. In the best possible way. Yeah, enjoy.
Can you tell us about how you got the
flavour out of the tawatawa? From the last one? Yeah. So I blanched it in baking soda and boiling water for 30 seconds, and then we just pulverised it up in the blender and strained it through a muscle pot. So what we have is a puff pastry crust with roasted carrots, courgettes, and the other one, eggplants, thank you. On top we have two char grills, capsicum sauces, we have a red one and a yellow one, and the gluten free ones, we have some gluten free white bread as the crust.
So what we have here is a gluten free polenta, citrus, and tomato cake. So tomato is the quality name for lemon wood. So what we're going to do is use the leaves and sort of make some kind of tawatawa. So if you don't use it, polenta cake. Yeah, on top we have a harakeke and almond praline and some green fennel.
So I think I'm just eating it at the moment, the citrus and tarata cake. I just love this type of cake. But you know, the funny thing is that I was saying that sometimes I don't really like things like beetroot, but it's the way it was made that makes you really, you know, it's really delicious. So I've loved every part.
I loved every part as well, but the kawakawa sorbet, if that was put into a tub with a price tag, I would buy it any day. It was amazing.
I'd say my favourite part of the meal was the sorbet as well, the kawakawa sorbet, and also the dessert. The whole thing was amazing, like the beetroot and the way it's been presented was amazing. Love it.
Honestly, everything was great. I agree that the kawakawa sorbet was good. I really like the ratatouille though, because I've never had one as good. And Baxter is an excellent host. Makes me giggle, it's really yummy, so thank you.
I just love the kawakawa sorbet. I really enjoy how Baxter takes ingredients that are local and just transforms them into something beautiful. Baxter's been doing these meals for the last, this year, and started at the end of last year, and he has a team of fantastic students who help him.
Inspirations. Definitely my team, we had different, you know, lots of different people come together and work on something really great. Probably 10 of us came together and, you know, all put our ideas in the middle and, you know, yeah, got something good. Minik Fiso, a haircut, my boss, she's, you know, really got me into the moldy ingredients. So we used harakeke, kawakawa, and tarata in the meal today. That's why we used it, so made me learn that kind of thing. Keep people healthy, really. Live longer. Good ingredients, better quality, nicer, taste nicer, fresher. Yeah.